Hello everyone, welcome to Maths Online Classes. In today's video, we are going to start the revision of our chapter 4 quadratic equations. Okay, this is the very first chapter of our term 2 syllabus. This is part 1. It includes the basic definitions and basic terms related to quadratic equation. Okay, so let's start with the video. The first question arises that what is quadratic equation? Okay. Any equation of the form ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0, where a, b, c are real number and a can never be equals to 0, is called a quadratic equation. Okay, it's very basic that a can never be equals to 0, and it is very important to always remember this also, because you can see that if I make a equals to 0, okay, in this equation ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0, if I take a equals to 0, then the term of x square will get eliminated. There will be no terms of x square left, because 0 into x square will be 0. So we are left with bx plus c equals to 0. Then it will become a linear equation. Okay. So we have all learned about the different types of polynomial, like linear, quadratic, cubic, biquadratic. So this is, linear is of degree 1, quadratic is of degree 2. The highest power must always be 2 for quadratic. Cubic is power 3, biquadratic is degree 4. Okay, so for quadratic equation, two things always to remember is, first, the highest power in the equation must be 2. There can never be any power less than it or more than it. Okay, so degree must be 2. Secondly, a can never be 0, because if it becomes 0, it will become a linear equation then. You can see that there are several examples related to n, like 2x square plus 4x plus 3. Definitely the degree is 2, highest power is 2. Then 5x square minus 7, x square minus 7x, and etc. We can see many examples related to it. Okay. Now, the very first exercise, that is exercise 4.1, focuses on checking whether a particular equation given to you is quadratic or not. So we will check that whether it is quadratic or not. So taking the first example, x plus 1 whole square equals to twice of x minus 3. First of all, to do this chapter, we must always remember the algebraic identities learnt in our previous classes. The very first identity applies here, a plus b whole square. So a square plus b square plus 2ab. So in x plus 1 whole square, we applied that. On the other side, we multiply 2 with x and 3 both. So we get x square plus 1 plus 2x equals to 2x minus 6. You can see that on the both the sides there is a 2x, so we can cancel them. And then after solving, we get x square plus 7 equals to 0. Since there is no term of x, we can write it as 0x, because 0 into x will again give me as 0. So we can write it like this. But we can see that the highest power is 2 here. Okay, it doesn't matter whether there is a term of x or not. Okay, we can see that the degree is 2, so we can basically say that it is a quadratic equation. Okay, now taking the next example, x minus 2, x plus 1, x minus 1, x plus 3. Simply we will multiply both the sides. We can see that after multiplying, x squared's term comes on both the sides and they both get cancelled. Okay, we can cancel both the terms of x square, and now we are left with 3x minus 1 equals to 0. So we can see that there is no term of x square. So basically it is a linear equation, because highest degree is 1 here. Okay, so it is not a quadratic equation. Now third question, x plus 2 whole cube, 2x, x square minus 1. Now again, a plus b whole cube. We have to apply the identity here. Okay, we cannot tell any equation by just looking at it whether it's quadratic or not, because there is a power of 3 here. We cannot say that it is quadratic or it is cubic, because sometimes the power of 3 can get cancelled out, such as question number 2. Okay, since question number 2 is like that also, that x square get eliminated. Okay, so 3 can also be get eliminated. So we have to first solve it, then we can check whether it's quadratic or not. Okay, so when we solved it, we got that the equation become x cube minus 6x square minus 14x minus 8 equals to 0. So clearly it is a cubic polynomial, because there is a term of power 3. For quadratic, the highest power must be 2, so it is not a quadratic equation. Okay, now the next topic is roots or zeros of the quadratic equation. This chapter mainly focuses on finding the zeros of the quadratic equation. And to find the zeros, we must first know that what are the zeros of quadratic equation. So what are zeros? Basically, that any value of the variable which satisfies the equation. That is, suppose you are given with any equation or any quadratic equation, and any value of x which, if you put in the equation, give me the same answer as the right hand side. If my left hand side and right hand side become equal after putting the value of x, then we can say that it satisfies the equation, and we can say it is the zero of the equation. Okay, so there are two things about the zeros. First of all, quadratic equation can have at most two zeros. Okay, a quadratic equation can have only two values of x or any variable which will satisfy the equation. Secondly, the quadratic equation do not have even single real roots, and that is, they have complex roots. There are some quadratic equation after solving which you will never get an answer as a real number. Okay, sometimes the answer will be like that: under root minus of something, under root minus of 3, under root minus of 5, under root minus of 100. Okay, so there will be a minus sign inside the symbol of under root, and these type of numbers are known as the complex numbers, okay, which we will study in our higher classes. Okay, so there are some quadratic equation which will not have any real root, and for that equation we will just leave the question over there and we will not solve it. We will just write it as they have complex roots, or you can say they do not have any real roots, or you sometimes you can say the roots does not exist. Okay, now let's take an example related to zeros. Which of the following is the root of this equation? There is an equation given to us, and we have to tell whether which of the following these four numbers satisfies the equation. So basically what we will do, we will just put the value of x as 1, 3, 2 and minus 2 in four steps. Okay, so very first step, put x equals to 1. When we put x equals to 1, we will get the answer as 1. Okay, which is not equals to right hand side, because our right hand side says it must be equals to 0. So it is not the root. Then if I put x equals to 3, again the answer is not 0. After putting all the values, we can see that there is only one value, that is x equals to 2 out of them, which gives me the answer as the 0, which is as equals to the right hand side. So basically x equals to 2 satisfies this equation. So x equals to 2 is the root of the equation. A quadratic equation can have at most two zeros, and for this equation x equals to 2 is one of them. Other can be found with the help of different methods given in this chapter in the next exercise. For that we will meet in the next video. Till then, keep revising this concept and take care. Have a nice day.